want y'all to give these young people, if you've been set free.
Mm. Hey, Jesus.
By the power of Jesus.
Yeah.
I want y'all to clap your hands.
Yeah.
I want you to dance.
That's right.
And I want you to lift your voices.
Yes.
Because when the sun set free.
Yeah,
it's free.
No chains are holding me.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank God for our young people.
Yes.
Their diligence and,
yep,
and their hard work and effort in the name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Because they could be somewhere else and be otherwise minded, but we are certainly glad that they are in the house of the Lord, serving the Lord and Savior Jesus, uh-huh, Christ. And in the beauty of holiness.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen,
Christ. Amen. We thank the Lord for that, and we do give God glory, honor, and praise. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Truly greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. We do greet you in the blessed words of grace and peace.
Grace and peace be multiplied.
In the name of the Lord, and we thank God for our being here.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's make our public declaration in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Before we get into the word of the Lord. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. There is but one Lord.
There is but one Lord.
One faith.
One faith.
One baptism.
One baptism.
One God.
One God.
Father of us all.
Father of us all.
That are in you all.
That are in you all.
Through you all.
Through you all.
And above you all.
And above you all.
Here, O Israel.
Here, O Israel.
The Lord our God is one.
The Lord our God is one.
The Lord our God.
The Lord our God.
Is God.
Is God.
Alone.
Alone.
And what's his name?
Jesus.
Jesus is, yes, his name.
Jesus.
We thank God that we know who Jesus Christ is.
Yes.
Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank God. Amen. Amen. For him.
Amen.
He is truly the Son of the living God.
Yes, he is.
And he is our way maker.
Yes.
Amen. He is our soul saver.
Yes.
And we do worship him, honor him. Mm-hmm. Bless his holy name. It's good to see each and every one of you out.
Likewise.
Assembly in the house of the Lord. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. It's good to see our sister Shaniqua Hall.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Assembling.
Thank you, Jesus.
With us today.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord. The outreach team went out yesterday. And,
yes.
God went out and began to pass out flyers for the church.
Yes.
Amen. For the ministry. And our sister was out there.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Y'all may be seated. I don't know why y'all waiting for me to tell you to sit down. You need to do everything you need to do. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
And so we thank God that the outreach team went out there and they began to talk with the sister. And,
yes.
And I came around the corner to look for them for service time, and they were out there talking to her. And the same individual, as Sister Shea said, that you see, amen, dancing around the house, yep, of the Lord, amen, is how she was out on the street.
Amen. Amen.
It's a beautiful, beautiful spirit. We thank God for her assembling with us today.
Amen.
Amen. And you've done my, I will say personally, you've done my heart good today.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Jesus. I too.
And here's why I say it, is that the freedom which you worship with.
Yes, yes.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yes, yes.
And I wish others would begin to catch on to that same spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord has freed you. You can twirl around the aisle and dance.
Amen.
You've been set free.
That's right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
They ain't trying to get with us today. But I'm praying that the Lord will send more individuals into the church like that.
Uh-huh. Amen.
Have liberty in worship.
Yes.
Don't mind freely giving God what belongs to him.
Amen.
It's beautiful to see.
Mm-hmm.
Don't care what nobody think about you. Some of y'all are too reserved because you're worried about what somebody going to say about you.
Amen.
Amen.
Let it go.
When you know Jesus for yourself.
That's right. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I thank God for it, and I want y'all to look at her as an example because she has an excitement about her Savior.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yes, she does. Hallelujah.
You have to be excited about Jesus.
Amen.
Because you want people to believe that you're in love with him.
Yes.
And I truly believe that you love Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Y'all, some of y'all look mad. Oh, well.
It's right anyway.
She loves Jesus.
Yes. Yes.
And that's what the world needs.
Amen.
And the world needs individuals that, mm-hmm, will brighten up their lives.
Yes, that's the truth.
You come in with a bad mood.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Amen. You should have somebody in the church that'll make you just want to smile.
Yeah.
You get upset, but you just want to smile.
Amen.
And she came into the church today, and we're going to get into the word of the Lord, but she came into the church today hugging everybody, picking, yep, people, and she didn't know who they were.
Uh-huh. Love.
I said, look at this. I said, this is the love of God.
Yes, yes.
So yes. Mother first had to look, double take and look at her. I said, she thought it was one of the young people. You know? When she looked at
realize it though. I don't know who this is saying. But it's
thank
a beautiful
Jesus.
Thing when you can walk into somewhere and let the love of God ready in all
Jesus, yes, yes.
Without having to know people's names.
Amen.
Know who they are, ever meet them before.
Amen.
That's the way we have to be in the house of God.
Yes.
And be very embracing. Amen. To the world, because some people are just simply looking for love.
That's the truth.
And looking at somebody just to smile at them.
That's true.
Looking for somebody just to hug them, embrace them.
Yes.
Because they're going through so much hell and heartache and trouble and disappointment.
Yes.
And looking for somebody just to
thank
bring
you, Jesus.
A
thank
breath
you, Lord.
Of fresh air.
Thank you, Lord.
Into their lives. In
that's
the
name the of truth.
Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm planning not to be before you too long by the help of the Lord. Amen. But I will give you what thus saith the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Jesus
Amen.
Christ. We're coming from the book of Psalms, the 11th division, and I'm going to begin at verse number 3. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, I just want to, amen, just talk just a little bit, amen, and just really visit some things by the help of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like the Apostle Peter, he said, I'm just coming to stir up your pure mind by way of remembrance.
Yes, yes.
These are not things that you are oblivious to or things that you are ignorant to.
Amen.
Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. But these are things that we just have to be reminded of. Amen. And there may be some individuals that don't know these things. And by the help of the Lord, we want to help them today.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Psalms 11, amen, verse number 3. The word of the Lord says, if the foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do? The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his eyelids try the children of men.
Mm-hmm.
Verse number 3 again. If the foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do?
Jesus.
And so I just want to repeat the psalm of the prophet David. This particular clause and the message for the day is, if the foundation be destroyed.
My God.
If the foundation be destroyed.
My God.
And as we begin to really look at foundation or what foundation is, we understand that the foundation is the basis of which everything is built on.
Amen.
You cannot build anything without a foundation.
Amen.
Everything in this world and this life has a foundation. The building that we're in right now has a foundation.
Amen.
Amen. And that foundation must be built properly and it must be built correctly in order for this building to stand.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's right.
So, foundation is very important.
Mm-hmm.
If you do not have a foundation or you do not have the proper foundation, everything that you're trying to build will crumble.
My God. Amen.
That's why Jesus would compare. He would compare individuals that are obedient to his word and that follow his word and obey his word. He said, I will liken them like unto a wise man that built his house on a rock.
Mm-hmm.
He said, but to them that will not hear these sayings of mine and put them into action. He said, I will liken him unto a foolish man that built his house, but he built his house on sand. And so both places were being built, but they were being built on two different types of foundation.
Amen.
So one was being built on a solid and firm foundation, while the other was being built on a faulty foundation.
Amen.
So you have two dilemmas and two predicaments. You have those that have no foundation at all, and then you have those that may have been built up, but they've been built up on the wrong foundation.
Jesus.
So David is going to ask a question, and he reiterates it in this particular passage. He said, if the foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do?
Amen.
And here I like that he does not just have foundation, but he has an S to it.
Amen.
It means it's plural. It means there's layers to this foundation.
Yes, yes. Come on now.
There are multiple things which the righteous are built upon.
Yes, yes.
Lord, I praise you.
Come on, Pastor.
And so because he uses the word S, that means it's not just one thing,
nope,
but it's multiple things
right
that the righteous is founded upon.
Thank you, Lord.
And if those foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do? When the foundations are destroyed, the righteous look like they're heretics, and the righteous look like they're the ones that's off when the foundations have been removed.
Amen.
The righteous begin to look ostracized, and they begin to be ridiculed.
Jesus.
When individuals choose to move the foundation.
Yeah.
And if you move the foundation, you gotta do some deep digging. You gotta do some deep digging. You gotta tear an already established building down.
Come on now.
And you got to dig within in order to destroy or to uproot the foundation.
Yes.
There's a lot of work that you got to put into it.
Amen.
In order to destroy a foundation. And so many people in religion today have begun to do some hard work in digging up the foundation that has been laid.
Amen.
And they begin to remove foundations,
Jesus,
that have been laid.
Yeah.
Y'all excuse me, I'm getting excited because I think my baby's about to walk through the door.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
So you got to do a lot of work.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
To dig up a foundation.
Hallelujah.
And so you got ministries and churches and organizations that are over zealous, and are working overtime to destroy fundamental truths that are clearly written in the Word of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Right? And so I don't want to be of the persuasion of people that I want to just jump on the bandwagon. But since it's one of the hottest topics out, we might as well talk about it today.
Come on.
About the movie Come Sunday.
Come on.
Dealing with one of Pentecostals, renowned or former renowned preachers, Bishop Carlton Pearson, who was a very prominent preacher, in Pentecostal circles, who ended up saying that he heard a word from the Lord.
Come on.
That God had spoken to him and began to reveal to him that there was no hell and that everybody was saved. And he came up with this thing and called the gospel of inclusion.
Yes.
The gospel of inclusion, it includes everybody.
My God.
Into God's plan of salvation. And says that everybody's saved. Now, I can get with you if you say that Jesus Christ died for the entire world.
Come on.
I'm with you with that.
Yes.
Jesus died for every man.
Amen.
Whether you're black, white, yellow, green, Japanese, Korean, whatever you may be, God died for you. He died for the entire world. He did not die for righteous people. He died for sinners.
Amen.
He said, I come for the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
That's what
he said. I came to seek and to save that which is lost. That's
right.
Why he came.
Thank you, Jesus.
So we do believe in a gospel that is inclusive. Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen. Amen.
I believe the gospel of inclusion.
Uh-huh.
Everybody's included in the blood that he shed on Calvary.
Hallelujah.
Firmly believe the gospel of inclusion.
Thank you, Jesus.
And it does not matter what sin you committed or currently commit, the blood still washes
away. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Your sin.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm all for the gospel of inclusion.
Yes.
It's for the entire world.
Yeah.
But we still got to stay within the confines of the scriptures.
Got to. Amen.
The confines of the scriptures are going to limit you to a few things.
Yes, come on.
There are certain things that you just can't do.
That's right.
And say that you're saved.
That's right.
That's just the reality of the matter. There's just places you can't go and say that you're saved.
Amen.
There are things that you just can't wear. The church go out of
here
and
come
say
on.
That you're saved.
Amen. Amen.
It's just
Amen.
In. Possible.
Thank you, Jesus.
But here is where I must stop with the gospel of inclusion.
Yes.
When it says that no matter how you live, or no matter how wrong you are still saved. Here's how, because saved people are going to go into the kingdom of heaven. Is that right?
Yes.
I feel like I'm telling y'all something straight.
Oh, no, amen.
Saved people are going to go into the kingdom of heaven.
Yes.
They are going to enter into that kingdom.
Amen.
But there are some individuals that will be living in lifestyles and doing things that cannot enter in.
Amen. Amen.
Now let's go to the Word of God. 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter.
Yes.
Verse number 9. And I want y'all to hear with a clear ear.
Yes.
With a good understanding of what the apostle of our Lord Jesus Christ, one who experienced
Jesus
on a road called Damascus,
come on now,
and he heard the voice of the Son of God audibly.
Hallelujah.
What he's going to tell us.
That's
now, you think I'm going to leave the foundation of eyewitnesses to believe a Johnny come lately?
That's right. Come on.
That was not an eyewitness of his majesty.
That's right.
That never heard the voice of the Son of God.
Right.
That never experienced God in these ways. You think I'm going to leave this foundation to go with another? Listen to what Paul says.
Yes.
He says, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
That's
that has just debunked the latter part of gospel of inclusion.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
It clearly lets us know that you cannot live an ungodly and an unrighteous lifestyle and still inherit or obtain or enter into God's holy kingdom. Let the church talk back to you. So now my question becomes, if you cannot inherit the kingdom of God, then what are you going to inherit?
Jesus. Come on now.
Because then he went on to teach that there was no hell.
My God.
Yes, there is no place of punishment.
That's what he said.
Or place of torment. And he said, God revealed this.
That's
to
right. And he believed.
But how will God reveal something to you that will contradict what his apostles and what his prophets said?
That's right.
And I just want to help the church real quick. And before I start getting into this, we're going to come back to this. Brother Jeffrey put a footnote on 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, because we're going to come back. But I want to jump real quick to another passage of scripture. Y'all ready? Let's go to 1 Corinthians, the 3rd chapter.
Mm-hmm.
1 Corinthians, the 3rd chapter, because I want to see what the foundations are that we're built on.
Yes, yes.
Because some people think that they're only built on a single foundation, which is Jesus Christ. Now, we are built on Jesus. He is the foundation, but he's not the only foundation of the church.
Come on.
Listen to what the Word of God says in 1 Corinthians, the 3rd chapter, and the 11th verse. This is what it says. It says, for other foundation can no man lay than is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, or precious stone, wood, hay, stubble, every man's work shall be manifested, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire. And the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. Amen. If any man's work abide, which he has built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved.
Amen.
Yet so as by fire.
Amen.
So now Paul gives us this account that we are built on the foundation, which is Jesus the Christ.
Amen.
But then Paul is going to give us even further depth of understanding concerning the foundation in the book of Ephesians, the second chapter, and verse number 20. Mm-hmm. Same Paul writing, right? So there's no contradiction in the word of God. But he's just going to further elaborate upon what we're built on, all right? Verse number 20 in Ephesians, the second chapter, it says, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets.
Yes, yes.
Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone.
That's
and
the word.
Whom all the building fitly framed together grow unto a holy temple in the Lord, in whom ye also are building together for an habitation of God through the Spirit. Uh-huh. So now he goes and takes us from a singular foundation,
right,
being Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And he adds to that foundation the apostles and
Amen.
The prophets.
Amen. Building. That's the word.
So we're built on a triple layered foundation.
Amen.
And that foundation is still one foundation, but that foundation is thick. We don't have a flimsy foundation.
Right.
We got a solid foundation.
That's
we
right.
have a foundation that is sure.
That's right. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
So we have a thick foundation that is almost impossible to be destroyed. In fact, it can't be destroyed.
Can't be. That's right.
Because it is too thick for any natural human being to destroy it.
Mm.
We are built upon the foundation of the apostles and the prophets.
Yes.
So if we're built upon the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, that lets us know that whatever they preached, practiced, and taught is what we ought to preach, practice,